up in the morning and out to school. The teacher is teaching the golden rule, American history and practical math. You study them hard, hoping to pass. Working your fingers right down to the bone, and the guy behind you won't leave you alone. Ring, ring, goes the bell. The cook in the lunchroom ready to sell. You're lucky if you can find a seat. You're fortunate if you have time to eat. Back in the classroom, open your books. Gee, but the teacher don't know how mean she looks.
That's hilarious.
That's the only woman I hit. Just kidding.
I heard, man, that girl was like, man.
I had vitamin water. It tastes like shitty shit, Kool-Aid, man. Kool-Aid.
What's that?
Shabbat.
Assalamu alaikum.
Water me up, y'all. Time coming at you to be like, what? And with five things to say to face, but so I'm out here.
All right, later.
Later.
Grandma's cookies.
Insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I let you love what I thought it was funny. You came along and woo, now honey, I've changed my mind, this love is fine. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Feels good.
My name is Ben Benedict from Akwesasne. I am an award-winning carver. I've won many awards throughout Canada and U.S., competing at the world level. Basically, self-taught carving birds, mostly. Growing up, I've been involved in lacrosse stick, the carving, working with wood. Basically, just finding a piece of cedar log and started carving a duck decoy at the age of 13. And carrying on from there, and I was sitting in a bench that holds the lacrosse stick, and he has the draw knife. So I put this in there, and I started using a draw knife on it, and that's what I came up with. Yeah.
That's nice. That's really.
I was 13 like years old when I did this.
Well, that's the beginning one.
That's the beginning
Can
one.
I hold it.
Sure.
Whoa. This is crazy.
It's light, huh?
Oh, sure is.
It starts right from thinking what type of habitat you want to end up with, how the bird is going to be, because you have to give it that essence of natural setting. A lot of my research is through carving books, and there's carving patterns in there.
Oh, yeah.
There's the side view. Start with drawing side view, top view, front view. You mark it all. I usually start with cutting out most of it with a bandsaw, and then you get to your knives and away you go. Basically, what I've done is I've drawn some feathers in this feather group. Feather patterns are not like bricks on a house. They don't go. And then you fill in the gap or whatever. It usually follows a line. You know what I'm saying? So first of all, you draw it out like that. And then you start carving away. I do have taxidermied mounts that were given to me from a taxidermist friend. Then I have the ultimate specimen to carve from. And this is a shoveler, female shoveler. There goes a feather. There's a female shoveler right there. See the feather groups?
It's hard to capture
right there. These are called the side pockets right here. And this feather fits into the side pocket when it's on the water because it doesn't want to get its primaries and secondaries wet.
Oh, yeah.
So it can fly quickly. I'm going to show you something. I'm making a door handle for a door. See? It's gonna be a canvas back head. Look at the detail on the beak.
It looks so genuine, like you wouldn't even tell. It looks so weird.
This is gonna be my leaf man. this was a log at the camp, and basically it's a face coming out of basswood, and he's gonna be all leaves. So it's just imagination. People's reaction. It's just a big high. It's the people's reaction toward what you've created. Yeah, that's the most rewarding. Like, you could win Best of Show, but if you win People's Choice Award, that's just awesome. Because you're not at the hands of any judges. It's the community. It's the people that come and see the exhibits. And they picked your piece for People's Choice Award. That's probably one of the best awards they get. You know how you get buffalo wings?